So we move on now to the women's 200 metres. It's the first round of this event. And in this first race, Ahure, but there are the records, and that is a formidable record, it really is. It was set in 1988 in the Seoul Olympics, 21:34. Astonishing, absolutely astonishing. Looks as though there could be an empty lane there in lane five. There probably is, so we'll just check on that. Oh, look at, yes, that's right. In lane six, in fact, it is that is missing. The young woman from Haiti. Well, there's Ahure at the Ivory Coast, a world indoor silver medal at 60 metres, but very, very good. She was seventh in the 100 final. She's established two records for her country this year, both at 100 and 200 metres. And she's got 22.42, her best time this year. Very fine athlete indeed, developing fast. Well, the British athlete, Adeoye, from the Enfield and Haringey Club, the new UK indoor champion, 23.09 this season. There's Federiva of Russia, the European bronze medalist over 200 metres in 2010. She won the Russian championships, was second in the world indoor champ 400 this year, so pretty versatile all round. 22.19 her best, which is pretty tough. And so the first three plus the six fastest to the semi-final tomorrow. Federiva on the outside, just inside Alison Peter of the US Virgin Islands. Miss Federiva, 22.19, former European junior champion, 100 metre hurdles, in fact, so she's been across the events in her career thus far. Absolutely flying into the bench. Is already up on Udo of Nigeria, and Ahure flying. So does Federiva right on the outside. But look at this one, Ahure. Federiva's got a lot of chasing to do here, but he's very strong indeed. Ahure is coming through to take this. Federiva in second place. And Adeoye of Great Britain, I think, is going to hold on to third. She does, and gets the qualification. But 22.55, and that's only a tenth outside her personal best for Muriel Ahure. Spoke to her in Paris this year. She really is a very confident young woman. Federiva qualified quite comfortably from the outside lane at 8. But a very, very good race to start the day, and a quality one too.
Personal best by Adeoye in third place.
And there is Gong in the shot put for her first round put. And that's the first throw that we've had this evening, just sneak over that 20-metre line. So she'll go into the lead. She's got the white flag, so big drive across the circle. Perhaps over-rotates that left shoulder, just departs a bit too soon. And she doesn't quite get the massive thrust that you need into that hand to get the shot put going out into the sector. But she's pretty pleased with it. 20 metres 13. And now Adams of New Zealand. Well, she seemed to lose balance a little bit at the front, but that's gone slightly further over the 20-metre line, and I think she knows she's missed that slightly. And you can see there that she just went down to the left-hand side instead of just standing up. She's a very tall young lady. But that will take the lead in the first round of this competition, and she's just sitting in her hands there, perhaps a bit more rhythm, but 20.61 takes the lead at this stage in this shot put final for women. And the next up into the circle is Ostapchuk of Belarus. Oh well, there you go. So Adams takes the first blood, because that's her main rival in defending her Olympic crown from Beijing. And The Belarusian didn't really get hold of that. And it's just over 20 metres. Although it may, when you touch the tape at that tape that's at 20 metres, sometimes when you hit it, it doesn't. Oh, there you go. 20.01. So Ostapac goes 20.01 in the first round.
Just another look at the fine bend running of Ahure. She really did. She got a terrific run into off the bend, a transition, and Federiva was okay, but certainly Ahure was the class act there. Adeoye of Great Britain, a new personal best, 22.94, and that's good for her. Just holding off Alison Peter of the US Virgin Islands. And remember, as I said to start with, we've got six fastest losers here, but Ahure very, very confident. And Federiva a lot more to give, I would think. But the Udo of Nigeria was the next home after Peter, so they'll go on to the faster loser list. So let's have a look at that. Ahure, Federiva, and Adeoye. 22.55, plus 0.5 metres per second, so that's quite useful.
And in the shot put for the second round is Tarasova of Russia. She had 19 metres exactly on her first round throw. And that looks as though it's not going to be quite so good. She splits the circle nicely. You're looking to get that right foot halfway across. There's lines that indicate the halfway point on the circle. And she went underneath it, but then there wasn't the fireworks you need at the front of the circle to strike it out there. So 18.80, she throws in the second round.
Coach looks very businesslike, doesn't he? No, that's how you do it. That's how you do it.
Well, you see, the left shoulder is such an, for the right hand, the left shoulder in all the throws. It's a crucial part of the technical elements of the putt, as it would be the javelin and discus. Koloko of Russia, the second Russian up, and that may be a slight improvement. She put 19.45 in her first round effort, and again gets that right foot into a good position underneath her to create the drive phase, the second phase of the putt, where the right foot turns and the hip drives in. So that's 19.52 for the Russian, and that's a slight improvement, and she is currently in fourth position. Schwanenitz of Germany, 18 meters 20 on her first effort.
No, I didn't like that at all. There were two parts to that. There was no rhythm in it. There was no continuity in the technique at all. She just short-armed it at the end. Have a look at this. There's two bits. Bang! That's very poor technique.
Yeah, it didn't flow. There was no rhythm, was it? It was like two hits. So it was land in the middle, stop, have a think, and then go again. And in all the throws, you know, that right foot landing and moving to engage the hip is crucial. 18.47 and her second putt.
Second heat of the women's 200 metres. Some big names here, most especially Alison Felix. Set a personal best in the 100 metres, but this is her parade event. Three world titles, two Olympic silver medals. She's got eight world championship medals in all, one of the great sprinters with a great range from 60 metres all the way through to 400 metres. And this is her prime event. 21.69 to win the US Olympic trials this season. And that comfortably heads the world list. Beautifully smooth run-up, and let's see what she can do here today. Should be no problem, of course, to qualify. First three sure to go through. Another big name on this field will be Debbie Ferguson McKenzie, go on the inside. And Alison Felix just being introduced to the crowd. Second British athlete, we've already seen personal best from Adeoye. This is Anyika Onwuada. Second in the UK Championships, a Commonwealth Relay silver medalist before. Comes from Liverpool. Simoy Hackett, student at Louisiana State University in the USA, runs for Trinidad. He's a semi-finalist in the 100 metres. Probably better at this event, 22.55 to her credit. Debbie Ferguson McKenzie, the world champion 11 years ago, goes on the inside, super veteran. Whole host of Commonwealth medals, of course. Then Gloria Hooper, fast improving young Italian athlete. Felix in lane three, Onuora in four, Janelle Redhead of Grenada in 5, Savlinas of Russia in 6, then Anim of Ghana, Suma of Senegal, and Hackett of Trinidad. Heat 2, the women's 200 metres first round. Well, they're away. Felix in the red of the USA, away well with Honorora outside her. Also running strongly, Savinas of Russia on the outside. Hackett of Trinidad also in the red. But this is Alison Felix now, coming into the home straight, running very smoothly, running very easily. Hackett still running very strongly, looks set to get second place. The crowd are cheering as to who might get third. Well, the answer is not Honorora, it's Redhead of Grenada, just ahead of both Honorora of Britain and Savlinas of Russia on either side of her. Well, 22.71, the wind is plus 1.2. Nice, comfortable first round of the 200 metres for Felix.
Adams in the shot put, second round putt. And she just ended up down on that. So as soon as you see any thrower that puts their chest and head down, that means it's not a good effort.
It was a good effort for Alison Felix. Let's look again at this race. Felix going in lane 3. Always running very strongly, very well. Beautiful bend runner. Didn't have to work too hard.
No, she didn't. That was a lovely, easy transition. Look at that. That is so majestic. She's so totally in control. Look at the contrast. And Hackett on the outside is really running it like a final. And one can understand that. But Felix is a different class. She really is. And in lane 5, as you said, Redhead of Grenada coming through. But that is poetry in motion. Wonderful for the youngsters to watch from the point of view of technique. It's not a lot wrong with that at all.
So, Alice from Felix, off she goes. She's, of course, already running the 100 metres. She'll do this, and she'll have a choice between the relays. Maybe she'll do both.
And next into the circle in the shot put for her second attempt is Ling Li of China, 1887 on her first effort. And that looks as though it's split the sector just slightly less than 19 metres, so that's going to be around the same sort of distance that she achieved in the first round. She was fourth at the 2007 World Championship, so 10 centimetres less, 1877 for Li of China. Next up is Michelle Carter from US of A. 1905, she currently sits in sixth position after the first round and these second round efforts. So this is her second round putt. Seems to get into a reasonable sort of position. Across the circle, but then puts that left foot, what we call in the bucket, and sort of follows it across to that side and doesn't block efficiently. So therefore the energy that she creates from the right-hand side to the left-hand side, there's energy lost. So slightly less, 1883 for the American. So Ostapchuk from the Belarus, second round effort. And that is an emphatic response to her first round effort, which she missed and went to 20.01. And she was in third position at that point. But that says it all. Seems to leave lose the hand away from the shoulder, from the neck. It's meant to stay very tight to the neck because it can be deemed to be other than a putt. 21.31, that's a massive effort from Ostapchuk on her second round effort. So this is Duco from Chile, 18.80 on her first round, and her second round effort, still quite disbelievingly looking at Ostapchuk's 21.31. And that is a substantial lead as we draw to a close of the second round of the shot. So 18 meters 70 for the Chilean. And that closes the second round. And we now move into the third round where the at the end of that third round, the field will reduce to 8, who will have 3 further throws. So, at the start of the third round, 19 metres 18 for the Chinese. And there's certainly quite a few holes being generated between that 18 and 20 metre line, predominantly falling between those. You can see the force that front foot hits the board at the front with and then reverses for the right foot to take its place. She stays in the circle. 18.74 for Luo of China. Very supple is Gong, her colleague in the Chinese team.
Another look at Alison Felix. That really was majestic. Look at the relaxation in the face. There's no tension in the shoulders. Absolutely superb.
Felix is winning time, 22.71 from Hackett, 22.81, and Redhead, 23.08. Onuora and Savlinis, in that order, sharing 23.23.
Well, there's Carmeleta Jetta. She runs in the fifth lane in this third heat. They're the fastest qualifiers so far. They're all six, so just keep your eye on that 23.46 as being the sixth fastest qualifier. But Carmeleta Jetta, world champion at 100 metres last year, silver medalist here. Fukushima in lane one. Taslakian of Lebanon in two. Silver, Brazil in three. Mothers Hill, Cayman Islands in four. Jetta, five. Belibaska, Asaki, I should say, of Greece, in six. Yepitan in seven. Simpson in eight. Jamaica and Asumni in Nigeria in lane nine. Well, what a great part she played in the 100 metres final here in these Olympic Games. A silver medalist. She really is a terrific athlete. 10.78 The Odin Oyepitan of Great Britain. She was predominantly injured since reaching that Olympic final in 2004 in Athens. It's good to see her coming back with 22.71. Sharon Simpson, she's in the eighth lane, the Jamaican Commonwealth champion 2006. She beat Veronica Campbell on that occasion. Equal silver in the 100 metres in Beijing. Great final that was. Not as good as this year, though. So,
on your mark.
Fukushima is lacking silver, another silver, Jetta, Belibasaki, Yepitan, Simpson and Asumni. Nigerian on the outside. I think Mothers Hill is not there, having introduced her. It is an empty lane, so my apologies for that. Lane four is empty.
Third.
Well, Jetta was absolutely motoring. The Yepitan going well outside of Yepitan. Sharon Simpson going well too. And right on the outside of Simley. So all the effort on the outside of Jetta coming through to take this. Very good run by Yepitan in second place at the moment. The young Briton going very strongly indeed. And she gets second place. Jetta, the Yepitan and Simpson. And that's 22.66. Very impressed with the Yepitan, being British myself. Very impressed, but even more impressed with Jetta, who is a real class act. We don't need to tell you that again, but 22.65. And the first three qualify by right. Yepitan, good to see her back. She's so deserves to be back. She had so many injury problems. But Jetta, coached by John Smith, he's got a stable of sprinters. And she did the job.
And we go to Gong in the shot put, her third round attempt. She went over that 20 metre line on her first putt. Was short on the right foot then. It didn't split that circle as far as it possibly could have done. It means you just tip forward that fraction, which then doesn't engage the hip the way you can.
I'll tell you one of the problems. It's creating activity in that right leg across the circle for the right-handed throwers. You've got to turn the toe in so that you can engage the hips.
19.91, so she's just down on what she did in the first round. Adams, 21.31, she's got to get over. It'll be a new PB if she does. Well, she's jetsoned it out to the sector over the 20-metre line, but her best ever is 21.24. Best this year is 21.11. So she's got to really motor somewhat to catch up with the Belarusian. So she is a very big, strong lady, is Adams.
Well, she's beaten the Belarusian pretty well every time out this season on the Diamond League circuit, so it would be a real turnaround here.
Well, she's on a run of 24 wins, so... I think Stapchurch is perhaps expecting rain. Perhaps she's seen the weather forecast and she's covering up.
Carmelita Jetta, winner of that second heat, or third heat rather, of the 200 metres. Look at the relaxation once again. You should see this. This is something you should see in the qualification of a 200 metres.
Can I just say that Adam's second put was 20 metres 70. It didn't come up on the graphic, so 20.70.
Well, there's the result of Heat 3, round 1, 200 metres for women. Jetta, Yepitan and Simpson, they're the three qualifiers by right, winning time 22.65, plus 0.7 metres per second the wind.
Halfway through the 200 metres, therefore, we've got three heats still to come. Shot put taking just a place just near the finish line, in fact.
And Ostapchuk is now coming into the circle for her third round put. She's 11th to go out of the 12, so there's just one more, and that will come to the closure of that third round where they reduce the field to eight competitors. 21-31 in that second round. Oh, and that's as far, if not slightly more. So... But she gets into a rhythm, it's like in, move across the circle, snap it out there. And that hand is a long way away from her neck when she comes to put that. And whether it's just me, but perhaps I'm a frustrated official, really.
No, I'll have a look next time closely with you, because...
21.36, so that's a slight improvement for the Belarusian. So she's gone 21.31, 21.36. Which is phenomenal shot putting.
Well, we'll have Fraser Price in action, the 100 metre champion, later in these 200 metre heats. In fact, she goes in the sixth and final heat.
What a performance in winning that 100 metres title. She's absolutely tiny and really is very impressive. In my view, arguably the best ever women's 100 metres final.
Certainly the best depth of times we've ever seen in any sprint race. Despite the fact it wasn't particularly warm. Well, Stapchuk, incidentally, he started the season with a Belarusian record of 21.13, then 21.39, then 21.58. So she's already ahead of what was her best before this year, twice in this competition. So in the form of her life, challenge for Adams.
Well, Adams has to surpass whatever she's done before. And I said earlier that she's actually on a run of 24 victories in finals, and there it is. Standings at the moment after three rounds of the shot put. So we have a Stapchuk with that throw of 21.36. Adams creeping a little closer, 20.17, and Gong over 20 metres as well, in third place at 20.13. Not making the cut are those from 9 to 12. So Tarasova, Duko, Schwarznitz and Miknovic are out of the shot put final at this stage.
Well, although she's going very well, she still keeps going over to make sure coach tells her any little minor thing that he should be doing.
Yeah, I think sometimes there's a bit of reassurance, but some coaches operate about, around the fact that you can't do this without me, and that's not necessarily the case.
Heat four of the women's 200 metres, there's the lineup, and the 400 metre champion, Sanya Richards-Ross, returns to action. So she's doubling up at 2 and 4, and of course we'll later see Fraser Price, who's doubling up at 100 and 200. Those are the next fastest after the first three so far. 23 seconds by Alison Peter looks pretty sure to go through. Let's see how fast these next two heats are. Richards Ross will be going in lane 8, all 9 lanes of this track being used here. And here's Jones Ferret, Laverne Jones Ferret of the US Virgin Islands, the national record holder at 22.46. Strong athlete who will be favoured to make the first three places. He goes in lane 4. So Sanya Richards Ross here in lane 8. This is Soto of Venezuela right on the outside. She's made a substantial improvement this year, taking the national record for Venezuela to 22.53. Well, she hasn't got much to back up that at the moment. Be interesting to see how she goes. The full lineup is Kai Selvon of Trinidad, who's a university in the USA, then Ovcharenko of Tajikistan, Stoy of Ukraine, look out for her. She goes in lane 3, European silver medalist. Jones Ferret, who we've already seen in 4. Arti Mata of Cyprus, another European finalist. Lalova of Bulgaria, the European 100-meter champion. Gonzalez of Colombia, Richards Ross of USA, and Soto of Venezuela. So a pretty useful heat, this one. And it'll be interesting to see how Richards Ross comes back after her 400-meter exertions. So away they go. Richards Ross certainly off fast on lane 8, and she's already overtaken Soto outside her. Strong run by Jones Ferret of the US Virgin Islands, with Stoy of Ukraine inside. Stoy in the blue vest, but Jones Ferret is taking the lead here at this moment. But here comes Richards Ross on the outside here. It's Jones Ferret in the middle there, and Richards Ross comes past quite smoothly. Jones Ferret and Stoy are the three who go through, and then on the inside, Selvon of Trinidad and Tobago runs fourth, and this was a good run. We've seen the Americans in prime form here. We saw Alison Felix in heat 2, we saw Carmelita Jetta in heat 5, and we've now seen Richards Ross, who is the second fastest in the world at 200 meters this year, running a fine time of 22.46. Jones Ferret took the early lead, but Richards Ross was so smooth in the home straight, so strong.
Yeah, she was, and Jones Ferret really ran hard off the bend, she surely did, and Lalova was going quite well at this stage in the red and green in the middle. She was going very well, and in contention right on the inside, Selvon of Trinidad and Tobago was going well, but then Richards Ross comes very strongly in the final stage, showing that speed and endurance, and she takes over from Jones Ferret, and as you said, a story of Ukraine taking the third place, 22.48, 22.64 and 22.66. I remember in New York watching Richards Ross run 22.09 in the Diamond League event out there.
Good time also for Selvon, 22.85, that'll go through, and Lalova, 23.01, every chance of progressing.
Yeah, yeah, certainly will.
Well, there's the pole vault. The bar has been at 4.45 for quite a while. Holly Bleasdale's had two failures, and a lot of athletes having troubles at this height, and she's amongst them. Anxious moments.
Yeah, I think the wind is tricky down that end, Peter, and Bleasdale had two attempts, and we've already had some athletes that have actually failed three times now. So this is her third attempt, so she's in last chance saloon.
30 seconds left.
Noise of the crowd tells the story. She can breathe a sigh of relief under extreme pressure. Bleasdale, the 20-year-old Briton, goes clear her third attempt at 4.45 meters. Well, credit to the girl. She was under a lot of pressure there. It looked a bit ragged, but the exclamation of joy, the other side of the bar, is self-explanatory.
Yeah, it's a pity it took, from the British point of view, a pity it took three attempts, because in any comeback situation that will work against her. It might do, and there's some behaviour. Yes, keep warm, keep warm.
The only thing I would say, Stuart, there are several competitors that failed twice in at 4.45, so in countback terms, they're all in the same boat, I think.
Yeah, there's quite a lot of athletes who would normally expect to clear that height too, and obviously having problems with the wind, as you say. Meanwhile, though, back in the shot, no problems on that count.
And we have Gong of China. Fourth down putt. Good shout.
Very consistent series, isn't it?
Well, she's almost putting it into the same hole every time she puts here. She went 2013 on her first, then it's 1987, then 1991, and that looks as though that's around 1990-something. So, or 1980. So, well, 1976. So look at that. She's going slightly downhill at the moment, so she's going to need some sort of stimulation to get up there. Adams, fourth round put. She needs 21-36 to get anywhere near Stupich. And there you go, 20 metres or just under. Red flag for Adams on her fourth attempt.
She just needs to get more elevation on the shot. I think it's a bit flat. I know she's tall and the big throws do flatten out the elevation, but I think she needs to get a bit more height on it to give herself the option of getting that range.
And the crucial thing is, Stuart, is the drive in first and the height comes off the front foot. So, you know, you block and you stand up, basically, and the timing of that is absolutely crucial. It applies to all of the throws. You have to drive the hip in. The hammer, perhaps not so much, but in shot, discus and javelin, you have to get your hip into it. Now, this is a Stupchuk's fourth attempt, and she's on a roll. Oh, wow, it's, you know, it's 21 metres again, so she really has got into a rhythm across the circle, which is allowing her to do exactly what we were talking about. Drive in to the front foot, stand up, hang on, and off it goes. We are being treated to an exhibition of world-class shot putting. Now, 21-15.
Well, meanwhile, back in that fourth heat of the 200 metres, this was Sanya Richards-Ross coming smoothly through to a fine victory in the fastest time we have seen yet in these first round heats. A very good one indeed. 22.48 was the official time. Jones Ferret 22.64, Stoy 22.66, and some good times behind it. Selvon Lalava and Arti Marta are all into the top six on times behind the top threes at the moment.
Well, we've got Veronica Campbell Brown in the fourth lane here, the Jamaican. She was bronze medalist in the 100 final, 10.81. They're the fastest qualifiers, the slowest time through to the next round, 23.23. So really, this is the fifth heat of seven, of six rather. And there is the lineup. Chan of Cambodia, Nguyen of Suriname, Sprunger of Switzerland, Campbell Brown of Jamaica, Samari of France, Perebo of Norway, Rosakova of Russia, Chavez of Ecuador, and Ryman of Ukraine on the outside. Campbell Brown, very, very much the favourite here. Twice Olympic champion at this event, the 200 metres. Defending Olympic champion then. Begins her campaign. This year, 22.38. Samari, the French woman, is in the lane outside her, won the European title of this event in 2010. Big improver on that occasion, 23.1 to 22.32. And this is Rusakova of Russia. So the Russian number two over 100 and 200 metres coming out of their trials. She's got a 22.42 to her credit.
Another one I think should be looked out for. We haven't singled her out, but I think Riemian of Ukraine on the outside is an athlete that's likely to progress.
First three to go through by right. Chen, Nguyen, Sprunger, Campbell Brown, Samari, Rebo, Rusakova, Chavez, and Ryman. Heat five. Straight. The Russian is going very strongly. Rusakova towards the outside, and here comes Campbell Brown, and outside Campbell Brown, Samari, the Frenchwoman, going very strongly indeed, and also Ryman on the outside. So this looks like a win for Samari. In fact, it's not. It's Ryman on the near side, and Campbell Brown and Samari. They're the three. Well, it was a good spot for you, Peter. He must be a statistician.
It was also at the European Championships when she ran very well indeed. She
was. Yeah, I know. She's done 22.72. Campbell Brown did enough, didn't she, to... It's 22.58, a personal best. Well, that is a very good start, certainly from the outside lane. She's just having a little bit of a celebration there. 22.58, that's pretty good. And Sumari, season's best, 22.70. Frenchwoman. And Campbell Brown, 22.75, she qualifies. I'm going to look at this. Sarkova was going quite well off the bend. There, and right on the outside, Ryamen of the Ukraine. But this is where Campbell Brown looks so easy. Very easy indeed. Sumari ran it a little bit harder. Look at this, she's really hammering down the straight, running it a bit like a final. And Ramien on the outside just comes through as the Frenchwoman eases down. But the first three through by a long, long way. There, you'll see the ease down in a moment. She sees Ryman coming through. And Ryman had to run it really hard, really, because she, on the outside lane, you can't see anyone until right at the end. So she's very pleased with herself, and so she should be, with a new personal best of 22.58.
So we have Li of China coming in for her fifth attempt. 19.28 is her best so far. And that looks as though it's better, much better. Right down splits the sector equally. So it's got the forces going right down the middle of the sector, which is always a good sign. And she stands up on that one, and that's going to move her perhaps up the field a little bit. So she punches the fist. She likes that one, it felt good. And off she goes to her coach, 19.63. And she currently is just outside the medals in fourth position.
I must say, I don't like this rule where they can run across and talk to the coach. It used to be not allowed, you know, and I think an athlete of this quality ought to be able to do what they do without the assistance of the coach at this stage in their career and at this stage in the competition.
Well, it's allowed now, Stuart, and they get coaches' seats close to the event, so she's Gong of China. Oh, and she's gone over 20 metres. She went over 20 metres on the first round. And then she's been very consistent in the high 19-meter zone. And for the second time tonight, she goes over 20 meters, and that's her best of the evening. Good shout. We like the shout. She likes it. That was a silver medal or bronze medal shout. Bronze 20.22 for Gong on her fifth putt. And that is the season's best. She's put 20.21. Vary Adams coming into the circle for her fifth putt. She's got to get going soon. And again, it's just missing. It's not connecting. She's under pressure. And she gets the red flag. So when you're leading, things are easy. When you're not and the pressure's on, it's not so easy.
Well, this was keenly anticipated as one of the great duels of the championship. But absolutely, Ostapchuk is outclassing her at the moment.
Wow, look, you can see 20.61 then improved slightly, but she's got three no throws in that. And you can't afford to waste, when you're competing at this level, to put pressure on your competitors. And the coach is just saying, look, you're going in and just staying in. You've got to drive the hip, hit the front foot, and stand up. Use your height, girl. Right, now Ostapchuk for her fifth round put. If it goes like the other ones, it's going to be over 21 metres. She's like metronomic tonight. She's into that rhythm. She goes in, she moves pretty quickly. She's not as tall as Adams by quite a long way. Shot, though, does come out towards the right shoulder. You know, it's not in the neck like I was told when I was young how I had to do it. But I'm just splitting hairs. I'm trying to find a full patch. But what a fantastic series we're being shown tonight in the shot put by this lady. 21.32, so that's just behind the best. But look at that series there. You know, it's 20, 21, 21, whatever.
It means four puts over what she'd done before she came into this season. She's already got a formidable record as well.
It really is quite stunning.
We're just going to update you with the result of that last one. Ryamien of the Ukraine winning that last heat, the fifth heat of the 200 metres, and we'll just confirm the result for you. Time 22.58, it's a personal best, plus 1.3 metres per second. Sumari and Campbell Brown then join her in the next round. That's the semi-final tomorrow.
And here is Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, fresh from that 100-metre triumph as she retained her title. This is an interesting lineup. We've got an existing star there in Fraser-Pryce, and also in this race is one of, I think, well, the outstanding young talent in women's sprinting as well. She's already achieved her aim with a double in the World Junior Championships. But in lane five, we have Antonique Strawn of Bahamas, who really is someone who's going to be very special indeed, I think, over the next few years. So it'll be interesting to see how she fares. Of course, she's achieved her main target for the year in the World Juniors, but how will she respond now to senior competition? She goes in lane five. That's Strawn of the Bahamas. So we've got Emmanuel of Canada, Fraser-Pryce of Jamaica, Gabriel of Dominica, Zabkina of Kazakhstan, Strawn of Bahamas, Casabona of Cuba, Sanchez of Dominican Republic, Dos Santos, Evelyn Dos Santos of Brazil, and Brizgina of Ukraine, former European silver medalist. But this is Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce. Doesn't run the 200 metres so often, but she ran 22.10 to win the Jamaican title this year, and that ranks her third fastest in the world. So although she tends to concentrate on 100 metres, just showing what she can do at 200 metres as well. And she's obviously very happy and very buoyed up by that 100 metres climb. There's Strawn, I mentioned before, 18 years of age, from the Bahamas. She ran the World Junior 100 meters, but she's much better at 200 meters. Takes a little while to get into her running, but when she does, formidable. She'll be going to university at Auburn University in the US this year, and very much an athlete, I think, to look out for in the future. But for now, Fraser-Pryce will be the favorite. Sixth and final heat, the women's 200 metres. Well, Fraser-Pryce has shot out of her blocks, already overtaken Gabriel outsider, then Zabkina, then Strawn, the Bahamas athlete I was talking about, and Casabona of Cuba, and a good run also by Sanchez, the Dominican Republic. But here's Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce easing along here now, and Strawn, look at her getting into her running when she goes well, and Brizgina of Ukraine completes the first three there, with Emmanuel of Canada on the inside, and it was Dos Santos as well, but 0.8 wind, and a clear win for Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, job done, at 22.72, with Strawn there in second place, just behind at 22.75.
We'll see.
Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce here winning the final heat of the women's 200 metres in 22.71. Young Strawn coming second at 22.75 and Brizgina 22.82. And the times of the fourth and fifth places, Dos Santos and Emmanuel 23.07 and 23.10. Enough to go into the next six fastest on times. Take a check, obviously, on the full composition of the semi-finals for that women's 200 metres. But all the favourites are through, and the list headed by Sanya Richards-Ross, 22.48. Hori, Riemian, Federiva, Jones Ferret, Jetta, impressive winner, of course, Doris Dumare, Alison Felix, the smoothest of the lot, looking for an Olympic title after those two silver medals, behind Campbell Brown, the last two Olympics, and Campbell Brown also safely through. So no major surprises, and that's the full list of athletes who will constitute the 24 who will run in the semi-finals.